evening, everyone. Welcome to Rochester Middle School, and this is our spring concert. And thank you for bearing with us. Our concert was originally scheduled last Tuesday, but they had a track meet at Plymouth, and several of the students were also involved in track as well as band. So Mr. Hawes was kind enough to reschedule it for this evening, and we're glad that you all came. Seated before you is our sixth grade band, and they're going to start the program with Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Thank you.
program, we're going to play a piece by Tchaikovsky. This is the theme from 1812 Overture. And the sixth graders would like to close their portion of the program with a patriotic song. This is called America the Beautiful.
Thank you.
thank you for bearing with us. Now seated before you is the 7th and the 8th grade band, and they're going to play their first selection, which is called Twin Cities March.
Thank you.
Now, we live in Rochester, Indiana, which is a little bit different than living in New York City or Los Angeles. Our next selection is a piece by composer Mark Williams, and the title of this is called Drive. So I want you to imagine moms and dads being in your car, stuck in traffic, driving 80 or 90 miles an hour on the expressway, because this piece of music really gives you that idea. This is called Drive. Thank you. Thank you very much. Every once in a while during the spring concert, the eighth graders ask if they can do a selection by themselves. Some years the students don't ask, other years they do, and they want to perform just by themselves. So this year the eighth graders said, we'd like to do it, and we picked the song by John Philip Sousa, and this is called The Washington Post March, and it's just with the eighth grade band. That I give the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade band students. And Mr. Ross, our principal at Rochester Middle School, is kind enough to announce the students' names, and I will hand them a plaque and congratulate them for a year's participation in the middle school band. So, first, could we have the 6th graders, would you stand on this blue line here, please, all the 6th grade band students?
Okay, we'll go ahead and start with the flute section for sixth grade. We got Lily Cashin, Madison Summers, and Elizabeth Swango. For the trombone section, we got Sammy DeVise, Mac Embry, and Anthony Peterson. And for the baritones, I used to play baritone. Good job, guys. We got Levi Border, Jacob Hamill, Gabby Meager, and Noah Swango. And for our percussion, we have Ben Border, Olivia Garrison, Aiden Mars, Jackson Musselman, and Carly Richard. For our clarinet section, we have Tessa Brooks, Molly Conley, Lexi Kelly, Gavin Lehrman, Amanda Romo, and Deanna Skiles. And for our trumpets, we have Andrew Bach, Ethan Brady, Grant McCarter, Calvin Sager, and Mark Schiefeld. Did we get all the sixth graders? Yes. Congratulations, sixth graders. Man, great job, guys. You sound terrific.
And then after they get seated, seventh graders can come out and run the blue line. Careful, here.
How Mr. Danhauser does this, it never ceases to amaze me how well 7th and 8th grade come together when they perform together. And I think he mentioned this in the fall, but one grade level will listen to the other grade level and try to match them through the DVD player. And it just is amazing how well they come together. So we got for the flutes, Paige Bodie, Tiva Freshhauer, Olivia Jackson, and Shelby Reisner. For our trombones, Dylan Weaver and Elijah Yarber. Section, we have Garrett Gray, Aaron Meiser, Kayla Miller, and Bailey Small. And for our percussion, we have Levi Ambergy and Blake Minnix. We have Megan McLaughlin, Charlie Pocock, Brittany Ramos, Olivia Regal, Jason Salyer, Maddie Tone, man, I might need bifocals. Nova Wooten.
No.
Nolan Larmen, sorry, my bad. I knew I'd skip one, because they're all together. And for our trumpets, Jared Adley, Tyler Holderman, Ashton Karras, Gracie Metager, Diego Ochoa, and Rachel Ricketts. For our alto saxophones, Liam Ringel and Susan Thomas. For our tenor saxophone, Bella Miller. Did we get all our seventh graders? Let's give another round of applause for our seventh graders. on, Mr. Danhauser. Some of our eighth graders had something that they would like to say, mostly to Mr. Danhauser. So who's gonna start this? Okay.
So, okay, she got her thing. So, throughout the years in band, he has come around sections and played with all of us numerous times and helped us on whatever parts we were struggling on, or maybe we didn't get a sharp or a flat right. And he's been extremely helpful throughout the 3 years that I've been here. He's taught everyone to play their instruments, to play them well, and I look forward to the next 4 years in band. Pass it on to Gabby now.
Hi, I'm Gabby. I play flute and piccolo, which is piccolo at night, and I'm in eighth grade. And Adam basically did the basics, but I just wanted to thank Mr. Danhauser for one specific thing. And you guys kind of knew where this was going, if you know me. About last year at General Music, we were watching all of the Beatles anthologies, and I was just like, oh, Paul McCartney. And then I listened to all of their music and got obsessed. And I mean, I should be mad at Mr. Danhauser because it's like all I do, but I've gotten so many friends from it, and it's all due to Mr. Danhauser, and I just want to thank him for that. So thanks for making me a nerd, Mr. Danhauser.
I'm Will Tone, and Mr. D taught me how to play the trumpet, and he's helped everyone learn how to play an instrument ever since sixth grade at the start of band, of summer band. He's came around in band class and helped everyone. He's our go-to guy if we need help with anything. So thanks, Mr. D. One more thing. If you're a sixth grader or seventh grader, you have more jokes to look forward to. Those are, you know, spot, yeah. Yeah, well, we'll call them spot on, but yeah, if anybody is a fifth grader here, you have many laughs to look forward to. I'm warning you about that now. Good luck.
Hey, thank you. Thank you, eighth graders, and thank you for saying this. The years go by sort of quickly, and I can remember when those students were sixth graders, when they first came in, and it's great. I always love teaching the new group of sixth graders that come in because all of my jokes are brand new. I can rerun them, and everybody thinks, oh, these are great, these are great. The eighth graders, I mean, they've heard some of those before, so it's no big deal. If any of you have not been in the middle school band room, it is a shrine to the Beatles, I must say. And when the kids do a Beatles unit, I have pictures, I have album covers, I have just a bunch of Beatles things. And I have a couple of kids in the high school that are really interested in the Beatles because of that. Some of the middle school kids really like the Beatles because of it. So they were a famous group 50 years ago, and they're still kind of, Paul McCartney is still out there performing and doing things today. So it's kind of neat that those guys have lasted that long. Because I remember my mom and dad said, I think those guys are going to be a flash in the pan. And boy, were they wrong. I mean, they really lasted. So thank you very much, eighth graders. And we're going to finish our program this evening. I have the sixth, seventh, and eighth graders together now. And we're going to start with the Star Spangled Banner. So if you would please stand and join us. We'll play our national anthem.
Thank you.
I've got three quick ones for you. The next one is a march by John Edmondson. This is called Omega March. South of the border and perform mariachi serenade. Thank you. I've got the lyrics in the program too, if you want to sing along, those of you that are Rochester grads.
Nice.